मॉर्निंग चिल. Yes, you are correct. We are now going to talk about future tense. What is future tense? The action which will be taking place in future, near future. It may be sometime at the end of the day, or maybe today at night, or maybe half an hour afterwards, or it can be tomorrow, day after tomorrow, next week, next year, next month, whatever it is. So action that are going to take place in the near future, in the, it's not over, it's not going on, it is going to take place afterwards, that type of sentences are called simple future tense sentences. Okay, the verbs that denote, that tells you that it is going to take place, the action is going to take place in future, is called simple future tense. Okay, so let us observe these sentences which are given on the board. Children, the first one, I shall go to my uncle's house next week. Not, I have not been, or I have not I am going now. I will go next week. So the action will take place. I have planned that I will go to my uncle's house next week. So this type of sentences are called simple future. Because you see, in simple future, we add shall with the verb. Now children, remember, shall is used for I and we. For both I and we. When I means the first person. Okay, I'm talking about myself. I. We means when I am there and with me some other people are there. They can be one or they can be many. Because I am also there and somebody else is also there, then it becomes we. So with I and we use shall. You can also use will also, but shall is only used for I and we. But with other verbs like they, he, she, it, okay, or any person, any place or anything, we use will. Okay, so in simple future tense, see here I have written shall because I have written here now. And then I have written the root form of the verb. Root form of the verb means the original form of the verb. It is called V1. Okay, the original form of the verb we have to write. You cannot write past it. I shall went to my uncle's house next week. No. You cannot write the the past form or the any other form of the verb. I shall go. So this is my future tense verb. I shall go. So shall go is the verb. Okay. Next sentence. Rita will do her project on Sunday. So she has not yet done, or not, neither she is doing now. She will do it on Sunday, means coming Sunday. So this verb you can see here, this will and do, shows that it is in future tense. Now Rita is one, but I cannot write will does. Rita is one. We are talking about singular subject, but we cannot write will does. As I told you, shall is used for I and we, and will is used for other subjects. Okay. So will do, it is the root form of the verb. The base form of the verb. Okay? So, will do her project on Sunday. Number three, my brother will drive the car. He has not driven the car. You can, no need, you can write tomorrow, you can write next week, next Sunday, next Monday, next Thursday, next month, next year, 2 years back, afterwards. You can write anything. But even if you don't write this, I can understand that this sentence is in future tense. How? Because will is there. So will drive. So my brother is one singular subject. But I will not write will drives. Will drive. So by this will and shall, we can understand that these sentences are in future tense and they are simple future tense. Number four, I shall not write a book. Again, you see negative sentences. I shall write the poem is in positive, I shall not. Now in negative, in future tense, you just have to add not. So I shall not write the poem. This sentence is in negative. So shall not is negative the base form of the verb or the root form of the verb. So shall not write is the verb shall not. It is negative. Simple future tense but in negative form. Okay? Number five, they will not run the race. Again, will not is negative. By not you can understand it is not negative. Now as I told you with I and we use shall, with they we will use will not. Now negative, and then you write only the root form of the verb or the base form of the verb. So they will not run the race is your verb. Okay? They will not run the race, will not run is your verb. Future simple. So in simple future, let's remember children, will, shall plus base form. So either you write will or shall and then the base form. These are your base form of the verbs. Okay? Base form of the verb. And in negative sentence, will, shall, not. As you can see, shall, will, not. And then the base form of the verb. So in this way, simple future tenses are very easy. With I and we use shall. You can also use will. Okay, will is also used. Okay, and then will, and then the base form of the verb or the original form of the verb. For negative sentences, will, shall, not, and then the base form of the verb. So we shall study tenses next week in this way, or he will not go to her uncle's house next week. In this way, positive and negative sentences in simple future tense can be written. Thank you.